A very good morning and good evening to all the participants.
So today we are going to see a new asset accounting testing part. New asset accounting is the only asset accounting solution that is available in SAP S/4HANA. Classic asset accounting is no more available in SAP S/4HANA. This key innovation taken within finance as a part of the part of S/4HANA with new asset accounting, there are many changes to data structures in classic accounting. And new financial accounting integration with the universal journal entries and also in the asset accounting parallel valuation. Previously, statistical data stored in ANEP ANEA ANLP and ANLP. But the new asset accounting with statistical data is now stored in a table. That is nothing but FAIR DOC IT table. The statistical data is stored in this table. And plant data is stored in ANLP and in ANLP previously, but now this plant data is stored in a table, that is flat underscore plan underscore values table. This is the table that stores the plan data. and actual data previously the actual data is stored in ANEK ANEP ANEA ANLP and ANLP. All the plant data is stored in previously. This actual data is now stored in a table called ACDOCA. Which is also called as Universal General Table. Asset accounting It means there is no longer any redundant data storage. In the new asset accounting, to complete, do the posting in real time in all the evaluations. Those T codes are no more available in SAP S/4HANA. The T codes like ABST, ABST2, ABSTL, ABUB, ABFI, ABF1N, and OAFV, etc. These T codes are no more available in SAP S/4HANA. There are few business functions exists in asset accounting. They are FIN, underscore AA, underscore CI, one and FIN AA parallel underscore VAL. FIN underscore AA underscore segment underscore reporting. These are the business functions in asset accounting. SAP ERP. Previously, in the SAP ERP 6.0, this business functions is delivered to be more flexible in the use of different fiscal year variants with parallel ledgers and with SAP ERP 6.0 XP02, financial parallel valuation business functions. In a business function supports us with parallel accounting. Now with SAP S/4HANA, the new business functions is completely delivered, which contains which contains only the segment reporting. Segment reporting. For assets, these are the business functions exist in asset accounting. And this is the release. There are many advantages by using new asset accounting in SAP S/4HANA. That is, real-time postings in all valuations are possible. And reading valuations made more flexible. And parallel documents for each valuation that post the correct values from the beginning. And also the simplification for your chart of depreciation. These are the advantages in SAP S/4HANA. With new asset accounting in SAP S/4HANA. So mainly we focus on creating the asset master record, display change asset master, and acquisition without order. Post acquisition, asset sales with invoice. Post asset retirement, by scrapping, and transfer assets within the company code. An asset, unplanned depreciation, these are the two apps released with the new asset accounting in SAP S/4HANA. We can also use transaction quotes completely on the backend system. That is AS01 to create the asset master record, AS03 to change the asset master, AS02 but the acquisition is also available in F90. AB is at 1. F92 and ABAVN. ABUMN. ABAL. These are the transaction codes we use in SAP S/4HANA backend system. In SAP Fury, click on SAP S4 IDS Fury. Let's create the asset master record. Click on the search icon. Double click on the app. Select the asset class. Enter the company code. If you enter the company code, all the asset classes will be available for the company code 1010. Click Find. Here we can see asset class is used to classify fixed assets in the asset accounting according to the asset type. Each asset master data must be allocated to in one asset class. Building, vehicle, furniture, asset classes combine all company codes. Once you enter the asset class, master data, provide the description. Click on time dependent, select the cost center, click on find, select the cost center, click on depreciation area, that determines the specific type of valuation, and these are mainly used in different classes in the asset master record. There are different types of depreciation areas. Local currency, past depreciation, now let us enter some testing related data, let us enter the period. Click enter. So once we enter this, once we enter all the required details, now we can see asset is created. Let us copy this. Paste it in the notepad. So this is the asset number, and the main asset number in combination with company code and asset sub number that identifies the fixed asset. An asset master record for an individual part or subsequent acquisition can be represented by sub number to the main asset number. If you want to see the created asset master record and enter display assets, click on display assets. Here, enter asset number and sub number is 0. Enter the company code 1010. Click enter. Here we can see all the details which we have provided for creating asset master record. Click on depreciation area. Here you can see different types of depreciation areas. Depreciation key. Click on time dependent. Here we can see the cost center. If you want to make any changes in the asset master record, you can go to change assets, click enter, and double click on the changed assets. Enter the asset number. Sub number is 0 and company code 1010. Click on the master data. Click on the time dependent. Click on more intervals. Here mainly focusing on the cost centers. Select the date. Click on yes. Select the cost center. Select click on cost center and click on sales. Here we can see if you want to see the changes, need your asset master record Click on mode. Change document. So here you can see the old values. It is changed to new cost center. Now let's post the integrated parallel valuation without order. Go to acquisition app. Let's go to the acquisition without order app. Select the acquisition date. Enter the company code 1010. Enter the currency UR. Here the post key is 31. Enter. Enter the account over here. Click on find. Select vendor account and click enter. Enter the amount 23,800. Enter the tax amount. Now change the payment terms to or select payment terms. This is payable immediately. Select. You select the tax code. V4. And enter the post key 00. Debit asset. Select accounts. So here select the asset master for 00009. Select account. Select transaction types. This is for external asset acquisition. Now click enter. Enter again. Enter amount, click on more. So here you can take the reference date, click enter and click on post. Here it is going to display the amount. Now click on post. So here we can see document was posted on the company code. If you want to display the posted document, then click on More, Document, click on Display. Here we can see the total amount is 23,800. That is 3,800. It will calculate this. Here, the remaining amount is 20,000 after calculating the tax. When we post document on the asset accounting, then it is going to post into asset accounting principles. Click on More, click on Asset Accounting. Here, the document will post into accounting principles. International Financial Reporting Standards. These are the two accounting principles. Here you can see two accounting principles. So click on this. It will post on any of these document currency or company code currency or group currency. Let's take company code currency. So here you can see debit total, credit total. If you want to check the amount is posted or not, go to Asset Value app. Click Enter. Double click on this. Enter the company code 1010. Enter the asset. Enter the sub number. Click Enter. Here you can see the 20,000 amount after calculating the tax. Here we can see local depreciation, local gap. Under this we have local currency and fixed currency. So until now I've shown you what are the changes. That's mainly on the testing on the SAP S/4HANA and how to create asset master records. And how to display the asset master. Now I'm going to show you asset transactions. So what transactions we have? Let us proceed. Under the asset transactions, we are going to see various non-integrated asset acquisition postings. And integrated asset retirement with account receivables. And asset retirement transfer asset within company code and asset unplanned depreciation. Under non-integrated postings, we will see asset with current year postings, asset with previous year postings, and also we can post multiple assets with previous year. Integrated asset retirement in account payables. Asset retirement means renewal of assets from the accounting. To understand the various options, so we have various posting requirements, that is retirement, retirement with revenue and customer, retirement with revenue but without customer. In retirement without revenue etc. These are the different ways of posting retirement. Asset retirement by scrapping. In SAP, asset accounting is required to remove remove partially or completely from assets . This is nothing but the asset by scrapping. Scrapping is nothing but the retirement of the revenues. Next, transfer assets . If a long asset class is selected, then an asset transfer within a company code is required. An asset unplanned depreciation. Asset unplanned depreciation is used for fixed assets. Which is used to handle unusual accounting situations in which the net book value and accumulated depreciation amount for an asset need to be adjusted without affecting the asset cost. In addition to the normal depreciation that you can schedule using a depreciation field, unplanned depreciation for individual assets in new asset accounting. On the relevant transaction types, the system recognizes that you want to post an unplanned depreciation. Let us log on to SAP Fiori. Click on Enter. Enter the user. W capital welcome 123 and click on the search icon. Enter the post acquisition . Click enter. Double click on the app. Enter the company code 1010. Click enter. Select assets. Now it will display all the existing assets. Select asset 500007. Now we will post existing content with select the document date. So this is the current year. Select date. Enter the posted amount. Now click on simulate. So once you click on simulate here, you can see the amount. And this is the technical clearing account to make specific postings. You need at least one technical clearing account for the integrated account acquisition. We have created this technical clearing account at the account reconciliation account in our chart of accounts. To read the relevant company codes, click on post. So here you can see the amount will post in two accounting principles, IFRS IFRS and LG. Now let's see existing assets with various years. Set another account. Enter the document date. Enter the previous year. With the new asset accounting, it is possible to post the existing assets with previous years, which is not possible previously. Now enter the amount, click enter, click on simulate. Here we can see the amount posted. Now click on post. Click continue. So here we can post new asset with the current year, and let's create a new asset. Select the new asset. Provide the description as machinery and define the asset class. Select 3100. Select the cost center. Click on find. Select one cost center. Now let us enter the current year date. Enter the amount. Now click on simulate. Now we are posting Now click on post. Here you can see and the amount will be posted in the new accounting principles in IFRS and LG and click on continue. Enter the asset. Select asset. Select one more asset. Enter the amount. 40,000. Here provide the asset description vehicles. Now we are posting multiple assets in the current year. Now click on simulate. Now click on post. To create we can hit the transaction code AF11. First, we need to create the asset master record. To create the subnumber, enter asset 500009. Enter the company code 1010. Click on time dependent or change the cost center. Click on find. And provide description as sub number 1 and click on save. So here we can see asset 1 is created. Provide the description as sub number 2. Click on time dependent. Let's change the cost center. Click on find. Select the cost center and click on save. And here we can see the sub number 2 is saved. Post acquisition link. We have created sub number for 500009. Here we have taken, click on multiple assets. Select the current year date. Select asset value date. Click on the sub number. Here you can see the enter the amount 1500, 800. Now click enter, click on simulate, here we can see the amount posted, now click on post, click continue. To check the amount is posted or not, the asset values app, click enter, enter the company code 1010, enter the asset 500009. Click enter. So here you can see the amount posted, sub number is 0. That is 1500. Now if you want to see the amount for all the sub numbers, replace 0 with star and click enter. Now here we can see the amount posted for sub number 1500, 800 and 2000. So here you see, you can see the amount posted just now. Let's see the reverse line items. And accounting transactions on a value that is posted that was posted in error. In order to post the reversal, we can also use the transaction code. Enter the company code 1010, enter the asset 500, 500007, enter the fiscal year 2018. Here we can see the amount posted for the Now here we are going to reverse the line items. Click on reverse. Here we can choose the reversal reason. So here we can see reversal for wrong posting and wrong prices and conditions. But suppose take wrong postings and click on content. If there was any error in postings, create with an app. Here we can see reverse a document and click on post. Click continue. Now next is integrated asset retirements on the account receivables. Now let us go back. Let us enter asset sales deed invoice. To understand the various options for integrated and for non-integrated asset requirements on the system, you can go for asset sales with invoice app, select the document date, enter the company code 1010, enter the currency UR, select the account, click on join. Select account here. Click enter. Enter the amount. Select the tax code. Enter the postings 50 and for credit postings, select the accounts, click on find. Enter account. Two double zero double zero. Click enter. Enter the star amount. It will display the amount automatically. And select the checkbox asset retirement. Click enter. When you select the asset requirement postings, from the asset sales account, a dialog box appears. Data will not come by default. Then we need to enter the data. Let's enter asset. Enter asset 00009. By default, the transaction type will be 210, retirement with revenue. Select asset value date. Now let us select the checkbox for complete retirement. Click on continue. Click on display document overview. Here we can see the revenue from the asset retirement account 700. 20000 in the chart of accounts. Now click on document, click on simulate, the posted amount is 11,000 and reverse from the asset sale is 9,000 and the output tax account is amount is 1,350. Now click on asset accounting. Here you can see the amount posted. Once we check the amount and click on post, here we can see the document is posted for the company code 1010. And paste it in the notepad. If you want to check the amount, then go to the asset value tab 500009, click enter, so here click on the transaction type, now double click on the current year acquisition with revenue, here we can see the previously posted amount. Click on view display document header. Document header. You can see the document header details. Click continue. So let us go back. Click on call asset reports. Double click on asset history sheet. Click on choose. Here we can see the asset history, report date, and created posted amount. Post asset retirement, swapping is nothing but selecting without revenue, click on asset, select asset value date, you click on enter text, click on additional details. Enter A for asset postings. Click on partial retirement. Select from current year acquisitions. Click on simulate. Click on post. Click continue. Transfer asset within company code. Let us see how to transfer asset within the company code. If any wrong asset class is selected, then in asset transfer within the company code. Now, let us go back. Enter post transfer, within the company code, enter, double click on the app. Enter the company code 1010. Select the asset. Select the document date. Select the asset value date. Enter the text as transfer asset sending assets is selected or not, provide the description, provide the description cars and bikes, select the business area, double one B1. Enter for all the depreciation areas. Then click on click continue. Then asset posting. Here we can see transfer variant, transfer within a company code. I click on the partial transfer. Click on simulate. I click on the other amount posted and click on post. Now here you can see the new asset is created in the company code 1010. The number 800004. And here the data is transferred one asset record to, that is 800003. Now click continue. Now let's see the asset unplanned depreciation. Unplanned depreciation is used in fixed assets, which is used to handle unusual accounting situations. Let us go back and enter the apps. Asset unplanned depreciation. Enter the company code 1010. Enter the asset 800004. Asset transaction type select. Unplanned depreciation for current year depreciation and click continue. Enter the amount 1000. Click on the line items. And click on the amount. The amount will post for all the depreciation areas. Click continue. Click on post. When we post the amount, if we want to post the amount, The same way, in the depreciation area, you would like to post the amount. You can post the asset transactions. In today's session, we see various non-integrated assets, acquisition postings, and how to post integrated asset retirements, account receivables, and postings, asset retirements by scrapping, transfer assets within the company code, and assets unplanned depreciation. If you want to see the assignment for today's topic, go to Dropbox Set to folder, go to Set to Assignments. Here, open S/4HANA Assignments. Go to S/4HANA Finance. Here we can see the assignments for asset master data and asset transactions. Let us open the assignments. Here I've given all the steps very clearly. Enter the app name, open the app, enter the company code. Enter the existing asset as, enter the document date and the fields. Like this, I have given all the fields.
Thanks for attending today's session.